question is how to maintain a ficus. Whether it's a bonsai or a ficus ginseng, the maintenance is quite similar. The resemblance of the tree is something else. A ficus ginseng has a swollen trunk to resemble a ginseng, a ginger root. A ficus bonsai is grown to resemble the image of a big tree in a small size. Both are available at a lot of retailers around the world. The ficus ginseng normally is a little bit cheaper than the bonsai because the detailed work is more in a bonsai than in a ficus ginseng. Ficus bonsai is normally the ficus retusa, as you can see here, also called the tiger bark ficus because it has this nice white dots on it. The ficus ginseng is a ficus benjamina root, which is grafted once or twice with ficus microcarpa, which is a small-leaved, very dense-growing ficus. The ficus likes a lot of water in the growing season. So the first thing you have to realize is, in your part of the world, whether it's the growing season or not. For example, here in Holland, the growing season is from May till September, October. At this time of the year, the ficus likes a lot of water. In the winter time, or when the days are shorter and the temperature is lower, the ficus doesn't need a lot of water. And it's really important to get your water and your feeding schedule into the season. When you water a ficus, you can water it excessively. So make sure all the soil is soaked with water. The water can run out of the holes underneath the pot, but the entire root ball has to be soaked in water. During the growing season, this can be every day, but please keep in mind that watering and time are not a one-on-one logical. Because when the sun is shining, the temperature is high, a ficus might need water every day. When it's raining outside, the humidity is quite high, the temperature is low, a ficus maybe needs water once a week. So please check your tree and check the soil, whether it's dry or not. You always have to wait till the soil is dry. Next important thing is fertilizing. Fertilizing for a ficus can be done all year, but during the growing season you fertilize it twice as much as in the winter season. Depends on the type of fertilizer. You can use a normal plant fertilizer. This will focus a little bit more on growth than on the overall health of the tree. When you take a special bonsai fertilizer, it will focus more on the overall health and a little bit less on the growth of the tree. So if you fertilize it, choose whether for a plant fertilizer or a bonsai fertilizer, depending on how many new sprouts and shoots you want on the tree. Third, after watering and fertilizing, is the position of the tree. Ficus loves light, so put it in the sun. Even in the direct sun, right behind the window, it's no problem for a ficus. A ficus has to be above the 10 degrees Celsius. So if you want to put it outside, it will love the outdoor humidity, temperature, the difference between day and night temperature, but it has to be above 10 degrees Celsius, also at night. So the minimum temperature for a ficus is 10 degrees. And then you can put it outside, on the garden table, somewhere in your garden. Here in Holland, for example, we can put the ficus outside from May, June, till the end of September, and then we put it inside again. Talking about bonsai, you have to keep in mind that there are three big aspects. The first is the botanical aspect. We've talked about water, sunlight, fertilizing, everything, the soil. All these botanic aspects are important. The second part of the bonsai ID is the technical part. Pruning, clipping, wiring, repotting, all techniques you use. The third part is the aesthetical ID of bonsai. Talking about the techniques, it's very easy to prune your ficus any time of the year, and you can even prune it anywhere. This is because the ficus is very well able to regrow even on the bald branches. So if you cut a ficus, you don't have to think about what you cut, but the place you leave, the twigs you will keep in the tree will give new sprouts just a little bit under your cutting place. If you cut the tree severely and you leave no foliage on the small twigs, you have to do this in springtime, because then the tree is able to regrow even if it has no leaves left. If you prune your tree in autumn or in the wintertime, then you always have to leave about 4 or 5 leaves on a small sprout, just to keep the sap flow going and keep the tree healthy. And it will give you new sprouts just in between the leaves. Another technique is repotting. A ficus has a very active root system, and it will fulfill the pot within a year or three. So repotting is a very important thing every 3 years. Please repot just before spring. So when the tree is coming out of the winter rest, it will start, you will see the buds come get swollen and start growing. And this is the perfect time to get your ficus out of the pot. Prune about 25-30% of the roots, put it back in the pot with fresh soil, and the tree will rejuvenate its root system and will keep healthy for a very long period. So pruning, repotting are very important techniques to use to keep your tree in shape and healthy. A lot of questions were about when to repot your ficus or your fig tree. It's important to check the root ball, so now and then. As you can see, I think it's about 40 or 50% filled with roots. When this is about 80 or 90%, so the outside of the root ball is entirely covered with roots, that's the right period to repot. Sometimes it happens that a fig tree or a ficus comes to a status quo. There is a technique which will help the tree to restart and rejuvenate itself. We call it defoliation. This can be done in summertime when the temperature is high, the tree is very active. You can cut it, you can cut all the leaves, so you get a bull tree, whether it's a ficus ginseng or a ficus bonsai. This is the moment when the tree gets a new growth, but everywhere on the inside of the smaller branches. So defoliation is a very good technique when your ficus has a status quo, doesn't grow anymore, the leaves might be a little bit weak or deteriorated by maybe some insects or something, then you can use a defoliation technique. Okay, the third part of the concept of bonsai is about aesthetics. Whether you create an image of an old tree with paint on canvas, or with stone, or with wood, bonsai is about creating an image of an old tree in plant material. Talking about ficus, there are two main ideas, the ficus ginseng and the ficus bonsai. Ficus ginseng is not primarily meant to resemble an old tree. It might be a good idea to wire the branches and bend the branches, because normally a ficus grows upwards. Old tree has downwards branches. So when you wire the branches and put the branches more downwards, the tree will get a more older image. This is something that can be done with every ficus ginseng. There's a ficus bonsai, whether you buy a retusa or another specimen, the shape is already there. The branches are already there, and it's quite easy to refine this idea by wiring the branches, spreading out the branches, so the layers of the foliage will get more dense and bigger and more mature. So it will, by time, refine and get more and more the image of an old tree.